Welcome back from That Should Break. You are still watching Urban Today right here on Urban Television. We're getting into our first interview this morning, and we're going to be talking to Ewane Mack from Ntare School, one of the organizers of the famous Ntare League that is happening here in Kampala. Mack, good morning to you. Very fantastic.
Yeah.
Why are you very calm and easy? You know.
I'm calm and easy because the final is tomorrow. Most of the preparations are done, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling great.
This is the only Ntare chap I know. Who is rowdy and disorganized? Who is making noise?
I'm very disorganized.
Are you listening to yourself? You're trying to defend yourself.
I'm not. I'm asking a question. Am I rowdy? Am I disorganized?
Mark. Yeah. Your offspring from Ntare School. But Mark, let us talk about the Ntare League. First and foremost, what is this league about, and how long has it been happening?
Okay, first and foremost, the Ntare Lions League is Sunday's premier all-boys soccer league. We started this league in 2014, around June. We've had 10 editions. This is the 11th edition.
Okay.
This league is all about creating a networking avenue for Ntare School old boys. So when we were creating it, we saw football as a uniting factor for those who have gone to the school. But over time, it has grown into more. People have managed to get some connections to jobs, to some pieces of work. People have managed to bring on other activities like swimming, like basketball, like all kinds of activities. It's grown into more than just football. So we've been in operation for like 6 years, and our eleventh season is culminating tomorrow, Kings Park Arena, Bulgaria.
What makes this league so different? Like, why does it keep on increasing every year? We're looking at the numbers that are increasing every particular year. Why do you think is that so?
Yeah, first and foremost, I'll take it down to there's the kind of unique character about Ntare Old Boys, whereby there's a uniting factor. There's no, I'm older than you, I'm wiser than you, I'm better than you. We all respect each other, and I think that goes a long way in connecting us as a community. But beyond that, that can only bring out a small percentage. I would also think the partners coming on board with attractive packages and making it more colorful, getting videos. We have sponsors like Jumia coming on board. We have UBL. We have PicShots taking our photography. So we have lots of partners, and they're also individuals who sponsor their personal teams. They bring out the aspect of the league in a more colorful way. That's what I would say.
All right. I want us to talk about, you know, your biggest fans or cheerleaders that you had back in the day. Boranyanji, which I believe was Boranyanji back in the day.
Yeah.
Where have you dropped the sisters? Are they part of this league? Do they come through to support?
Yeah, they're part of this league. We have a fixture for them every weekend. They're part of this league. They've been in this league for two seasons, and we can't thank them enough. Each and every year, they keep bringing more and more people, and... Yeah, it's really colorful. They're a really good group of people. Yeah.
Some people who do not play, who do not particularly
like this
league,
one.
Like
why
this
are you pointing at?
Why?
What have I done?
What reason do you have for not partaking in the Ntare Lions League?
The first time I heard about the league, the first of all, what is it, a trophy?
Shield.
Or a car? It's a shield.
You didn't even know what it was.
No, I have to be honest. But the first time I heard about the shield, it was in London, and it was doing tours around. So I was like, what's happening? What the hell is this? What's going on? And someone is like, oh, that's an Ntare League. And you know, I've been wanting to be a part of it, but because you know, it's a beautiful thing. So I started by joining like a group of Kajogo, and it's fun. I have to tell you, it's fun. It's fun.
Fun.
No, every time I post, I think about some of those messages.
Exactly, I think about the videos also.
But it's fun. For me, I would like to ask, what's with the tours of the Shield?
Yeah.
The Shield tours came about. We were introduced last season. We'll have to give all credit to Inshire FC, the last season 10 champions. Their name is here.
Okay.
At the bottom here, the current holding champions. Mm-hmm. They started this idea of. What if we give this a world tour? Like the World Cup does a tour, the Cricket World Cup Trophy does a tour. All these things do tours. Why not we do this? So they started taking it to England, to Egypt for AFCON, all these things. So that's how the idea was born. And we've ticked off about 6-7 cities: Oman, London.
So when it is doing the tours, is there some funding being solicited? where does this money go anyway?
Who are you worried?
Well, we have Benzi J in the
world.
We have some local. I want to talk about, you know, these names that we are seeing. You know, and like you just mentioned, that the previous winners we have Nshera, Bonshe, Kashoro.
Don't forget season 7, Kabali. That's my team.
Kabali. So what do these mean? What do they stand for?
Now, when this league was being started, people thought of, if we give them ordinary names, it wouldn't make sense. So people were like, why don't we give our team name something unique to the school? So, you know, those kind of unique, I'd call it slang, things slang, we have in the school. Things that represent meaning to the school, to give it more of an identity, more of a cultural backbone. So all these names, some of them, I don't think I can say them on TV, but... Okay, now like Kashoro. Kashoro was the school canteen. Mugudu is... Boshe as a deputy headmaster has been serving for about 30 years plus at the school, and he knows each and everyone's face who has gone to the school. So he's kind of a cult figure at the school. Chisianga, that's the morning porridge we take at the school. Number 5, Boshe again, champions. Avashwechi, those are like...
the snakes.
Yes, the snakes. That's the snitches, them niggas. Kabali, that's the defaulter's card. The one you sign when you make an error or something in school. Abazivu, that's self-explanatory, and Nshera is it's also porridge as well.
Okay, so Mark, as you do get to wrap up, when is the finals? When is it happening? Where? What time? And you know, should we come through with money or it's free of charge?
The finals are going down tomorrow. Kings Park Arena, Buyogerere, the home of Pirates Rugby. The function starts at about 10 a.m. with placement games for the day, but the major event, the final between Abashwechi, two-time winners, and Ebichunchu, who lost last season's final. It's going down tomorrow at about 4 p.m. You're all invited. I'll send you an invite later on after the show is done.
Okay.
One more thing I'll just add in is the captain of Abashwechi. He's also called Aine Derek, so maybe maybe that's something to...
Yeah, I think I should come through and support Abashwechi.
Yeah, maybe that's something to hold on to.
You need to watch out for
no,
the...
No, but I think this particular Aine Derek needs to play for Mugudu.
Why?
I think I would go for Kashoro.
Kashoro.
Mugudu. There are more names. There's also Kajugo. We haven't talked about...
Useless.
No, Kajugo isn't actually useless. One of the biggest...
You have never won this shield.
We are coming. we are strong in other aspects.
But anyway, thank you very much, Mark, for coming through. Of course, let us make our way to Burger and be part of the biggest Italy Lions League, as far as you know. You know, they're celebrating the footballer and the name of their school is concerned. In case, you know, all goes well and they come through the BM Street somewhere so that you don't see me, because there'll be a chopper guy in Italy. Guys, anything could happen like it used to. But anyway, we're going to be a first data, so I'm definitely sure nothing like that is going to be happening. I mean, today does get to go in for a very short break, but when we do get back, we have, you know, some little littles that will be joining us for yet another beautiful interview.